discuss about how to percuss the abdomen. So as I told you, first the inspection, then the auscultation, and then the like a percussion. So now in the percussion, what we are going to do, why we are going to do the percussion, so that we can know that whether there is any abnormal collection of the air or whether there is abnormal collection of the fluid inside the abdomen, so that we have to assess for. So as you all know that again, we have divided the abdomen into four quadrants, and we have to cover all the four quadrants to know about the like any tympani. So as I have explained in the previous topic also, tympani means any collection of the gas. Okay, so tympani will be normal in the little bit epigastric region, where we will be able to find some of the like a area of the tympani, right? Then next is, as I told you, in the respiratory system also, that in the area of the lungs and in the area of the liver and in the area of spleen, we will be having the dullness. Why the dullness is there? Because there is no air, there is the solid mass. Okay, because the liver and the spleen is solid mass, so we will be able to hear the dullness, as we have done in the heart also. Okay, so in some area of the abdomen, we will be having the dullness due to the liver, due to the spleen, or due to the other organs also. Okay, and in some area we will also find the tympani, which is due to the air collection. But just imagine if all over the abdomen you are able to hear the tympani, that means you are only having the air. So what that means? That means there is some kind of intestinal obstruction. That means the person is not able to pass the gas from the abdomen. Okay, and if you are able to feel excess of the dullness in the abdomen, so what that means? Dullness means the solid thing. So that means the organ inside the body is enlarged. That's why you are able to hear the abnormal dullness. Okay, so it should be having the scattered, like to say, tympani and scattered dullness, but it should not be having excess of the dullness and tympani in the abdomen. Okay, so what to do? As I told you, abdomen is divided like this. So we can start from the lower quadrant, that is the right lower quadrant. So what we will do, we will keep our hand like this, and we will be using our middle finger, or you can use the two fingers. Okay, but preferably we used to use the middle finger. So what we will do is, we will be having the tapping like this. One, then so like this, we are going to cover all the quadrants of the abdomen, so that we can note all the tympanic notes. Okay, that means whether we are able to find the dullness or whether we are able to find the like a tympani in the abdomen. So as I have already explained you, that if you are able to feel the dullness all over the abdomen, that means you are suspecting that some abdominal enlargement is there. Like what abdominal organs enlargement? Like hepatomegaly, like splenomegaly. Okay, so these things you can assess. And if there is extreme air you are able to feel, that means only the air kind of tympani you are able to feel. So what that means? That intestine is not able to release the pressure of the gas. So that's how you can assess for the percussion. Okay, so all these methods you have to cover. Once again, I'm showing you from here in the lower abdomen, we can start one, then in this upper abdomen we are going, and then in the other side we are entering, and then in the other side of the you can say upper quadrant, and then in the lower quadrant. Okay, so a particular pressure we have to keep on the abdominal organ, so that we can feel the vibrations which we are keeping or not. Okay, and one more important thing I need to tell you, that when you are percussing the abdomen, okay, so there can be some shifting dullness and fluid thrill. Now what is that? You have to see for the abdomen for excessive enlargement. There is condition like ascites, in which abdominal will be filled, abdominal cavity is filled from all the fluid in it. Okay, so in that, what we will do, we will little bit tap the fluid like this. Okay, we will tap like it is the big abdomen, and we are tapping the fluid like this. So what is going to happen? All the fluid will go in this area and it will come back. So with this, we are going to give the fluid thrill. That means the fluid thrill we are able to see. Okay, and we are going to tap that abdomen like this. We are going to punch that fluid in one side, and again it is coming. So we are going to shift the dullness in that area. So we have to check it on the abdomen, like if any ascites is possible on the patient or not. Okay, and for ascites, one more important thing you have to remember, that there will be some striae. Okay, striae means just like pregnant women will be having on abdomen, so there will be extreme striae will be present on the patient's body. Okay, so if any white striae you are able to see, so if it is a female patient with the white striae, so what does that mean? That means the female was pregnant once again, previously. And if the light pink striae you are able to see on the patient's abdomen, that means currently the female is pregnant. Okay, and if bluish, purplish colored striae you are able to see, so that is a condition known as Cushing syndrome. Cushing syndrome means when your cortisol level in the body is increased, so due to that the body will be having the striae of blue and purplish discoloration, and due to this ascites ascites also, because in the obesity and the ascites, when the fluid is like so much in the abdomen, so it will be enlarged, and due to that the bluish discoloration will happen. Okay, and one more pattern you have to see on the abdomen, like dilated veins of the abdomen you are able to see. So that means the female is pregnant or the female is having the ascites. Okay, so that you have to look for. Then once you have done with the percussion, so now what you're going to do in the percussion, as I told you, you're going to check the dullness, you're going to check the tympani, you're going to check about the any kind of enlargement of the organ. Okay, in this you are not going to palpate it. In the palpation we will discuss how to check the enlargement, but this percussion is going to tell you that whether there is possible enlargement inside or there is the possible intestinal obstruction. Okay, so that's all about the percussion. So now in next video we will be discussing about the palpation of the abdomen. So thank you so much. Stay tuned.